Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to learn how to increase boot partition space in Redhat 7 or Oracle CentOS 7. Okay, so in this video I am going to show you step by step how to increase the boot partition space. This is not actual boot partition resize, so I am going to make a new partition and I will going to swap the current boot partition content into the new partition. So we can do it step by step. Let me see that. So currently my boot partition space, it is around 500 MB, so I am planning to increase into around 2 GB or 2.5 GB. so let me do it step by step. So run the lsblk command and we can see I have a hard disk SDA which is around 8 GB. In that I have the two small partition like SDA1 and SDA2. So SDA1 used for the boot purpose and SDA2 used for the LVM, so which I am using for the operating system like root VG file systems. Okay, so now I am going to create one more partition from the SDA, and using that partition I am going to swap the slash boot content into the new partition. Then I will boot up the system with the new boot partition. So the first step, we need to create the new partition, so whatever size we give. So I am going to create a new partition with the size of 2 GB. So still my hard disk having around 3.5 GB free space, so from that I am going to create additional new partition with the size of 2 GB. So let me create the partition. For to creating the partition, we can use the fdisk command slash dev and sda. The first step, we can print whatever partitions are we already created. Press P and make it enter, and we can see there is a two partitions are there. One is for SDA1 that is used for the boot partition. The remaining, the second one is SDA2 that is used for the root VG LVM. So let me create a new partition. So I'm pressing for creating a new partition, I'm pressing for N and make it enter. So by default it will select the primary partition, so I'm making enter. There is no changes, and the default automatically it will choose the default partition number. So after the second, the third partition will choose. So I'm making enter, and automatically choose the first sector which is available after the second partition in end sector. So I can see it is already default is so chosen. So I'm making enter. So last sector, it is asking how much size you need to make. So I'm going to give the size in around 2 GB. So I'm making make the size, we have to make plus 2 GB. I'm making enter. Now we can see the partition 3 which is created with it 2 GB. So we can check using the p command. So we can see it is created. So also we need to assign the, already it is created with the 83. So let me do it one by one more time. So for that we have to choose type, and by default the partition will choose 3, then make it enter. The code it will ask, so I'm making the code 83. Now we can see, yes, it is created. Now make it as a permanent partition. Press W. Once it is done, just execute the partprobe command. Now we can see newly created partition, that is SDA3. We can see SDA3 is created and it's around 2 GB. Step number 2, once a new partition created, so we have to format the partition, so whatever file system we require. Currently the current boot partition is type is XFS, so I'm going to format the newly created partition the same file system type. So to make the file system XFS file system, we can use mkfs command, mkfs dot XFS then partition name. So it is saying already formatted option, so I am just making -f for the force format. Yeah, it is created now, and we can validate it once again. Yeah, we can see the partition. Now what I am going to do, using this slash dev sda3, I am going to mount with the new file system. So let me create a new directory called mk directory slash boot, which is already created. So fine, we can, if you are not created, you can create it as per your convenient name. Then mount this SDA3 with new partition. Mount space slash dev SDA3, then new port. Once it is mounted, and we can check the mount status. Yes, it is successfully mounted. Now we already know we are going to copy the whole content of the slash boot partition. So I am going to copy the whole boot partition content into the new partition, which is size of 2 GB. So I am using this normal cp command, so you can also do it the same way. So for example, now I am in slash boot, so I am using the cp command. Using these options, you can do it the same method also. Just make it enter. Yeah, we can see now all the content is copied into new boot. So once it is done, blk id. From the blk id command, we can get the partition number 3 uid. Just copy this partition id and go to the etc fs tab. Once you copied the blk id, so this is the sd3 blk id, and go to the etc fs tab. So you can command it the first entry and add a new entry uid equal to with the newly created partition, then copy paste remaining everything, then save it. So what I did, I created a new partition with the slash new boot, and I copied all the content of the boot partition into new partition, then I modified the etc fs tab entry. So now everything is done. Now reboot the system and wait for the boot. You can see my system is currently booted. Let me take the duplicate session, restart the session, and again log into the system. Now we can check the boot partition. So we can see the currently boot partition, it is mounted with the SDA3, which is amount of 2.0, which is almost 2 GB space. So this is the one of the method how to increase the space if your hard disk, means the hard disk SDA, you can run the lsblk command. If it is having the additional free space for the primary partition, you can follow this method. I hope you like this video. Thank you. Thanks for watching.